Friends and fans, introduction to Indian ragas. In this series, I've been playing many popular ragas, rare ragas, tricky ragas, pentatonic ragas, hexatonic ragas, melakarta ragas, all kinds of ragas are there. And I'm so happy to be playing all this in this beautiful location like this. And this is Saddle Mountain in Oregon. So I did a hike. It's like a 2.5 mile hike. And then you're on top and such a view. That's Pacific. And then that's Columbia River merging onto Pacific. There's nothing like this I've seen before. Such a beautiful feeling. And I want to be a student always. That's like, you know, there's nothing like I'm a teacher and I'm not going to be a student. If a good teacher has to be a good student always. And learning never ends. And if you are not a good student, you cannot be a good teacher. I can promise that. And always it's like, whenever I play with any musician, it's learning from each other and, you know, spending time, you travel. So I'm doing this Jugalbandi tour with the Santur. So, and then yesterday, Sandeep Chatterjee was playing this Koushik Dhwani. I love this raga. I know this raga. But there's always so much to learn, and then there are so many Hindustani ragas which are so beautiful. And this raga, I just it's very close to my heart. And I know this raga, you know, previously when I toured with I think Vishramohan Ji, he played sometime. And you know, I just like this raga. So I want to play some special raga at this great special locations. So I saved it. And you know, each raga gets its opportunity at different locations. Randomly, it chooses its own location. So here we go with Koushik Dhwani. Sa ga ma da ni sa sa ni da ma ga sa. Such a nice pentatonic scale. You don't have to. You just be in the scale. The raga is so beautiful. You just stay on the note, and you can enjoy the raga. That's what I do. Let me do a quick alap of Raag Kaushik Dhwani. And I've done many ragas like this. Carnatic ragas, Hindustani ragas, difficult ragas, easy ragas, all that. Check it out. If you are a Carnatic music student, Carnatic music lover, check out my website, carnaticlessons.com. Free apps are available for download. You can search Carnatic Lessons. And then you can download the app, enjoy all the interviews, all these raga recordings at various locations. I'm like trying to make as much free content so that everybody can enjoy. If you're a serious student, Carnatic music student, there are many lessons. I have close to 1,200 videos on the website. And you can, if you really want to learn flute or vocal or any other instrument, check it out. Okay, here we go with Raga Kaushik Dhwani.
Thank you.
Kaushik Dhwani, and I don't think there's anybody out there in this saddle mountain on the summit. It's only we are here, and I can go on and I can spend a lot of time here. I feel like not going back. I think we have to get back now. So, you know, Madhyamam, Devatam, all these notes, I feel so happy when I touch those notes. You know, I don't like to move to the next note. I think it's a good thing for all the students to practice that. You have to develop the patience in staying the note. That there's no point in randomly just going up and down and up and down. I used to do this because I've done all these mistakes and I've learned my lessons, and that's what I like to share it with my students. So there's so much to learn from Hindustani music. I have so much respect and regards for this other forms of music. That's even Western music. When I play with these musicians, oh my God, their seriousness and it's so much to learn. You know, when I was touring with Pandit Vishwamohan Bhatt, always priyas, always practice, you know, morning, you give him an amp, he's so super happy to practice and play, and it was such a learning experience, you know. They've accomplished so much, and all this Padma Vibhushan, Grammy, everything he has got, and who would do that? You know, on the day of the concert, riyaz, morning. Next day, okay, concert is over and I was with him for many days. Next day, riyaz. Every day he likes to play. That's what he wants to do. Always thinking about it. You know, very inspiring, and it's such a learning experience. And I like to learn all these North Indian ragas. Technically, may not be perfect. The chalan might not be. But, you know, with my Carnatic background, whatever the best possible I could do, I've done. But if you are really serious, I'm sure all these great legends have sung this great raga. We can check out, and I will post some links. You know, I can check with all my Hindustani friends and see who has done the best version of this Koushik Dhwani, and probably post those links. And I'm sure you can search and you can find that great legends have sung this raga. It's such a beautiful raga. Pleasure playing this. See you all in another beautiful location. Especially, I don't know if I had an ability to capture, it's just, it goes maybe 2,000-3,000 feet down below. There's nothing, you know, if you drop something, that's it. Such a beautiful place, and the range of the mountain. Oh my God. You have to be here to enjoy this. And, you know, nature is God. That's what you have to do music in the nature, outside. It's always fun playing concerts, but it's more satisfying and more so much pleasure playing out in the nature. No reverb, nothing, no gears, just the pure sound of the flute, tambura. It's such a pleasure, and I hope I enjoyed doing this, playing this, and hope you all enjoyed this raga. See you all in another beautiful location. Bye for now. I want to thank my friend, Murli, for spending the whole day with me and bringing me here, shooting this video for all of you to enjoy. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. See you all then. Bye for now. Oh.